His day three MJ of the Arukh HaShulchan Yomi. If you'd like to sponsor an upcoming shiur or more of the Arukh HaShulchan Yomi, please contact me directly. We very greatly appreciate it. Today we're doing Simon Reish Yud Beis, Siv Dalid, through Simon Reish Yud Gimel, Siv Dalid. And we're talking about Ikra B'Tofel. Moment. The Zosha Rabbeinu Rambam B'Sipah, Hodim Barchan Al Ikra, Pachim Ad Fela, that which make a bracha on the primary and exempt the secondary. It's only if you eat them together, or you eat the primary first. But if you eat the secondary first, you want to drink, they want to eat a little bit first, Kadesh lo yishtel the regular in order not to drink on an empty stomach. Or you eat the berries, to sweeten the drinking, which will come after you eat the berries. Make a bracha on the food first, even though it's a secondary, to subordinate to the drinking. And you only make a bracha, however, on the shahakol. So it goes down a level because it's secondary. Lamar Midvarav says, we learn from the Rambam that even if you should bracha on the secondary when you eat it first. Goes down 11, only is shahakol. If the ikar is also a bracha of shahakol. However, what the Ramah means in this case, what's inferred here, is that you make the bracha on the secondary, and then it comes out you don't need a bracha on the ikar because it's a bracha. Those who want to say that you make ikar and bracha of shahakol. Even the primary is not shahakol. Nevertheless, you only make a bracha on the tafel of shahakol. Even though it has a different bracha than the primary. Even though it has actually a higher level bracha under normal circumstances. Since it's a secondary, well, this way I understood the first shot, but obviously that's not what the first shot was saying. First shot was saying that specific case where the bracha is shahakol on the tafel, but here it's saying that even the bracha on the tafel would be ha'etz adama, you would still make a shahakol on it since it came when she failed. Neither man ikar bracha, since it's secondary, the primary bracha has been removed from it. Macharim baruch, let's say make a shahakol. Macharim baruch, ikar bracha, and then on the primary food. You make the probably bracha for it, which is the Shulma Sedeshin. The Bilon here, this is not clear, says Zohar Shulchan, and Megamagabam, though he also wasn't clear. Mishabura says that in fact you make a bracha in the tafel only shakol, because it's tafel, and loses its primary bracha. And he says, Chatkhila, it's best to refrain from eating the tafel before the ikar. Which makes sense, of course. The Shara team says that that's to take into account those little base yosef. Then when you eat the tafel before the bracha, you make before the primary, you make on the tafel the appropriate bracha for it, whatever it is, or eat sadama. So therefore, in order not to run afoul of that shita, by which you do, by doing Ramal Shahako, it's best to eat the ikar first in any event. Back to the Rosh Hashanah, that shish chas, those who are chim a tafel chavi lo biyoser. If the secondary is more dear to him, tell me baruch atafel b'chol yom. He doesn't make a bracha on the secondary, no matter what, first or second. This is the Tazmali Rabbah. Zeh shnei hafachim b'noi se echad. This seems to be a paradox. The im hu chaviv alav, if it's more dear to him, ain't no tafel. It should be secondary. If it's tafel, if it's secondary, ain't no chaviv alav, it's not more dear to him. He says in brackets, fatin emes, the halacha is true. That you make a bracha on the tafel, but it's because it no longer has a din of tafel. See, Bob is bar over there. More will be explained about this in see Bob. Hey, Yeshivam is sometimes Shafila pass you chashim mikol davar. Even bread, which is more significant than anything else, become tafel. Nonetheless, comes secondary. The Zeshon Rabbeinu Rabbi Yosef see Alef. But you pass you chashim mikol even bread, which is more significant than anything else, even tafel. If it's secondary, konchel geochel dag maliach says you are eating. Herring, bracha passing when eating bread with the kadesh lo yehi zikein b'gronu, so it shouldn't damage your throat. Mevarach ha'adav, make a bracha on the fish. And protest the passing exempts the bread. Came when she was talking because it's secondary. I come to shorten. Klomar, meaning she ain't what's up achilas paska. You really don't want to eat the bread at all. Okay, which any kar achilas she'll pass, and since your primary eating is not the bread, before the bread, any bracha don't make a bracha on it. Fees according to this, she'll routinely still see on itself when you want to drink whiskey. Make a little ktas paska and prepare for yourself a little bit of bread, a bluska ktana or a small cookie, in order to restore your heart. Then you turn your kodesh beachilas, and your primary intent is not to eat them. The bracha and tzaraf shakol make on the whiskey, a shakol potter or something, and you exempt them. V'day, you should know, you should say, v'aday, shakol tov ein el achilim muetes, lo shiva leiv. Now, you should know that this is definitely, the end I would say tough about this, when your bread you're eating is very little. It's only to restore the heart, or shalom, it can be going not to hurt your throat. V'aday, tzaraf tov, lo bracha, rishon, lo bracha, that's, you know, require first or last bracha on the tuffel. I will choose a pay, even a lot of bread, or anything else of that sort. Lo shachli goes to tuffel, can't call it secondary. And Kari Rea looking there for all God fearing people, Monima Satsumam, they could reframe the kakafu, pas koshu, even a middle amount of bread, or glusko koshu, even a middle amount of pastry, shame, lushame tuffel, for the purpose of being secondary. Akhe shesias mayam, and sort of after drinking a little bit of whiskey, kederach o'elam, like people do, who can make an honest and precise reckoning in this matter. We mentioned this before, that if the secondary is more dear to him, Baruch Allah, make a bracha on Eifach HaKadosh, Baruch Allah, you can make a bracha on the primary Akal Shana. We already expressed our astonishment in Sib Dalit. If it's more precious to you, it's not tofel. But tzarchamar, the zel peyush shorosh, the shemayim b'skim and reish. You have to chavi mikri mashchavi love tami. So you have to say that this is going to the commentary of the rosh, who holds that chavi is that which is always chavi. In other words, generally, not just in this specific case. Basically, that thought in a chavi b'love, and so you can say now specifically it's not chavi b'tim. The chavi tofel, that part is secondary. I came to tumer kavlah, but since under normal circumstances it is dear to him, chaynser the bracha b'fnei atzma, and therefore needs its own bracha. Any ikar poto, and the primary does not exempt it. In ein brachos kriyas ikar, unless they have the same bracha. Because under chaynser brackets chaynser b'grasi test, it's about tanya mashkos b'zev chayn kam dvarish because simzev lo nis baruli ayin chamduk. It's not clear about the rest of the about tanya rights. She brings those who argue and say that even when the secondary is chaviv on him, he should make a bracha only on the ikar. And the Shratzir, in fact, brings that down on locha. So that the Rosh Hashanah did a little bit of interesting, innovative interpretation here by the synergy between the Rosh and the Rambam's opinion by chaviv. But Mishnah is not having any of that and saying that even if it's when the Tavah is Chaviv, you make a bracha on Iker. Again, that will not address so much the Arukh HaShulchan's question from before, how do you have such a scenario in which the Tavah, the Chaviv can become Tavah. Va, Pashu Kshishar pass behind Sarah, but if you, when you dunk bread into whiskey, or gluska, or cookie, or lekach, or tort, or other pastries, I'll be sure coming also on Yain, Sarah, and Nilabo, even though your intent is for the whiskey, which is absorbing it, Mikomkom, Hemi, Kari, nevertheless, the pastry is primary. Yain sort of tuffel and the whiskey is secondary. Baruch hamotzi, make hamotzi, the turn to yain and you wash or mevarch mazonos, or if it's a pastry, you make a mazonos. Potay yain sort of aniv lebo, and you exempt the whiskey which is absorbed in the pastry. The chen kshishor b'yain b'sharim mashkin. That's true. Also, when you soak it even in wine or other beverages, yeshem mishachag that those distinguish between koyim achila, does a baruch lapas, then you may then you make a baruch on the bread. And achar achila, when it comes to some kind of dessert, that he wouldn't make a bracha on the bread. It's like the chiluk b'zeh, I don't think there's any distinction. He was talking to the rei and sort of bracha. If it's in the meal, does require bracha? After brachas mazon, if it's after benching, it's leinu shakon nevshav b'sochel suuda k'mosh k'savnu b'sim akuf ayin zayin. By us, everything is considered to be within the suuda. In other words, it'll be a part of the hamotzi. By the gamazon pas ikar, the whiskey be subsumed in the bread. Tzarchim. Not clear what exactly would happen here. Never seen anybody who soaked their whiskey in bread after benching. Vazim no mizan should refrain from this. If you want to have a beverage after benching, Ishna Mashkil Vada, Vibarchala. drink it by itself and make a bracha on it. Mishnah Berurah brings down the Magen Avraham, the halacha, who says that there's a distinction between before eating and after eating, and he adds that the rabbi seems to say that it's best in this manner, that in this matter that you should drink a afterwards a little bit of whiskey before you soak the bread, and then the bread would can be tougher to the whiskey. In any event, okay. Ches. Because of Rabbeinu, we say seed to the seed base. Mirkachashim nichim arukikim dakim. The if you take a confection and you put it on a flat kind of cracker, rakikim arayt fela the mirkachas. Those crackers are subordinate, secondary to the confection. We know that people don't have mind to eat that bread. They only come to hold together the confection on them, not to make one's hands dirty with honey. Nevertheless, if you eat the confection by itself, and then you eat the flat bread by itself, so you have to make a mezonos, so only because you made him an ikar by having it afterwards. The only thing I think of like this is the Israeli krembo. Except for the krembo, this is not particularly prevalent. And nowadays you connect the confection to the cookies in order of flatbread in order to give a taste to the cookies of flatbread. And have your kikim, so the flatbread is primary, and the confection is secondary. You only make them selves. A certain type of pastry, shemitagni kinamon, where they fry cinnamon, ime gozim, with nuts, ushkegim, and almonds. It's totally mime maker. It depends which one is primary. Imarim bam purperlach. I guess it's some sort of grain. Then come out some ragdi, it's only done just to hold the stuff together. Mivarchin adama, you make adama being lab, and if not, mivarchin mezonos. I think he threw that in the end because we kind of finished the section on Hichos Brichos Aperos, and now we're doing Reish Gimel Din Hotzi Achem, Rabbi Yochanan, how you motzi others when you make a bracha. Friday's bar, we already explained, and Simikuv Chosam Hatzayin, the Rabbi Yochanan, any kibichas and mitzvahs. Brachas and pleasures are not like brachas and mitzvahs, she'echad yachol otzi. One can exempt his friend. Even already fulfill his obligation. Because all Jews are responsible for one for each other. It's not true by brachas and pleasures. He will alone and atav. He is not getting pleasure now. He can't be mostly others in his bracha. The bezel lo shayach arvus. This there's no concept of responsibility for each other. Shenachavah their responsibilities by mitzvahs where their obligation. Is on each person, and I'm obliged to have them out. But there's no obligation to have Hanah. That's a person who cannot exempt others unless he eats and drinking with them. And then they yotze by hearing his bracha. If he has a mind to exempt them. And if he's and they have a mind to be yotze with his bracha. This is true. Even they didn't answer amen. Because listening is like responding. Your bachelor has tiku, but he was only don't interrupt with talk. Yeshua, Shem, Baruch, and Baruch. At the time, the person making bracha makes the bracha. Chaynim lo yishom ua bracha mitchila zosa at sofa. Also, they didn't hear the bracha from beginning to end. Now, if you honor amen, if they answer amen, ain't no team de chavosin, they not fulfill the obligation. Tzrich and the Baruch, Baruch, and the men need to make a bracha on their own. Chaynim eno ocha b'shos himoam, also he's not eating or drinking with them. Birech ba'adom, and he made a bracha for them, nevertheless. Habi b'chas abatol, your bracha is for naught. Echad b'rach n'atzol, they must go back and make their own brachas. Elin came, baruchu imo b'yachad mon achra ma'ashomer. Let's send the bracha together with him. Mila b'mila, saying the same thing he did. Beis, b'simu kubsa mazayin simcha b'av nizbar. The besuda in a meal, the inyan b'chas ha-motzi, terms of the bracha of ha-motzi, and I'm assuming you'll see in b'chas ha-baruch, and I came yachshu v'aseba. There it said, well, they only yotze if they all sit reclining. done. But according to us, we also said back then, Habi Yeshiva Sabi HaShulchan, sitting around the table is Kaseba, is like reclining with the two for them. But we're not accustomed to actual reclining. Kasla Tuv Shalom Sif Av, Al Kol Peiros Yishari Vorem Chutzim Pas Yain, the two Urim Shulchan are both right, on all fruit and all other species, except for bread and wine, Imayu Ochlim Shnaim Al Yoser, if there are two or more people eating together, Echad put this chaver afilu below a seba, one can exempt his friend even without reclining. Yeshiva mi aboy, but they have to at least be sitting down. Dafka pas manis b'zili by bread and wine to chashibe, which is thinking that boy a seba you need to be reclining or at least sitting. You don't have yeshiva kum a seba to do, and for us sitting is like reclining for them. Pisa di don't leislan has seba, but according to us that don't have reclining, actually been pas the yain shad for him. There's no machine, bread and wine, anything else. The Yeshiva feel pas the yain echam v'rakum we've been sitting. Even by bread and wine, one person makes a bracha for all of them. The Shalobi Yeshiva, and when you're not sitting, we're standing, I feel shadow of mine, even everything else, call a couple of our class, or anybody should make their own bracha. This is the end of the quote from the Torah Shulchan Aruch. Kimo Beret Vorin. The explanation of this is that the Bekamacha, Lohan Uzkar Din Shari Vorin Klav. Let us mention other, a lot of other foodstuffs at all. After pass, not us only by bread, it says there, the Torah HaSeva requires reclining. The Yain Yesh Plukta B'Gemara Shem, with wine there's Machlokes with them. Torah HaSeva, if you need to recline, or Dai B'Yeshiva, it's sufficient to sit. Oh, the Gama Seva Lo Mahani, or I've seen reclining doesn't work. We time the Ainu Zekrius, because it's not a formal setting. Poska Poskin, the Poskin ruled Kach Lishna, like the opinion of the Yain Shoba B'Pas, that wine is like bread, Mishum the Yain Choshu, because wine is significant. Ruling the Shlosim Yain, and most parties, drinking parties with wine. The Shad Vayim and other those foodstuffs, they said, based on logic, that Haseva is not relevant. It's not going to be truly make it, doesn't make it truly formal just because you're going, if it's not something significant that you're eating. Without sitting, certainly one person can't be most. The other show, I feel a pasnan, seeing your bread, it says, they're sitting down, not reclining, everybody makes their own bracha. For us, if you're sitting but not a formal way, each person makes work for himself. Certainly in other forms of eating, because you have to sit down, at the very least to sit down in order to be able to with other people. And the sitting has to be like a formal sitting. If they just sit down for the purpose of being able to break, immediately get up, we'll make a yeshiva cloud. It's not called sin at all. They call echad mevarach atzma. Everybody should make their own bracha. Da'av gam zehu rak bebracha b'shoina. This is only for the first bracha. Shoina l'ischa b'yachim, when they're coming together, they're standing together, or they're about to come together. B'shivasim l'echol with the sing down tea. Only shlosh with the drink. Va'av kikvias, and then it's a formality. Does echad yachol tzias achrein. Then one person can accept the others. A bracha achroina. But bebracha l'sham nim parei, they're ready on the verge of splitting up. They must divide and split up. No person is exempt. The others, each person makes their own bracha. It's not like the benching collectively. The zimun connects everybody together. That designation connects everybody together. But since my fruit, there's no zimun. There's no zimun for our fruit. They remain separate entities. The yearly says Roshon to me, it seems like I'm shocking possible kiss that you're being a Mazonis. Shibros and Mazonis came and shocking blow Kriya Suda, since they eat without a formal meal, blow Shir Kriya Suda without the Shir, which makes a formal meal. Dina compares to others like fruit, below Dami Yai, just shows in my bay. It's not like when you drink a lot of wine. Therefore, each one should make their own bracha. Ukshokhlin Shir Kriya Suda, and it tells us that Motsi, but also Mosa, but they can pass them on, but they eat enough to make it a formal meal, then anyway, they need washing and hamotzi and brachas hamotzi, and of course, like any bread, one person can hamotzi the other.